Hey, everybody, it's Dr. Zubin Damania, ZDog MD, if you're nasty. Okay, this vaccine thing, everybody's talking about 12 to 16 to 18 months to develop a vaccine. Government officials are telling us this. Here's why that's supremely unrealistic and that we shouldn't hang our hat. Now, vaccines are the exit strategy from this ultimately, as they have been for numerous diseases throughout history, but people don't understand, and I did an interview with Dr. Paul Offit, who has co-invented a vaccine for rotavirus. People don't understand how difficult this is to get right and be safe. And this is why, unlike medications, where people are sick often when they take them, so they're willing to accept a certain amount of risk of side effects and complications, with vaccines, you are giving healthy people, including children, this vaccine, which means if it has a 0.5% chance of causing serious harm, you could potentially do more damage than the viral pandemic itself. So you really have to be careful. The reason I advocate vaccines is that they are safe and effective because they've been through years, if not decades, of research. The fastest vaccine we've ever developed was the mumps vaccine, and it still took like 4 years, all right? So why does it take so long and what could go wrong with vaccines? Here's the thing. With vaccines, there's many different approaches to how you make them, but ultimately, you're generating some sort of protein that looks like the business end of a virus that then triggers your immune system to mount a response that neutralizes that particular protein. So when the real virus comes, your army's geared up and ready to go, and you knock it out before it causes harm and can replicate a lot and so on. And that makes a lot of sense. But it turns out, in order to make that protein accurately, it better look really, really, really close to the original virus. Because if it doesn't, you can get a phenomenon where you create a response to this protein that's not quite right. And instead of neutralizing the virus, you get these things called binding antibodies, which then actually help the virus enter cells through a process called antibody-dependent enhancement. The bottom line is you could, through your vaccine, make things worse. Now, this has actually happened with a modern vaccine, the dengue vaccine. So the first iteration of dengue vaccine, young children who'd never been exposed to dengue actually had this phenomenon of antibody-dependent enhancement and got sicker when they were exposed to dengue than they might have if they had never gotten the vaccination. That is why you need to study it very carefully in humans and animals. You need to make sure you understand what the dose should be. You need to do a placebo-controlled trial in this case where you can actually see, is it effective and is it safe in enough humans ultimately that we're comfortable going to the next phase. And you still won't be perfectly comfortable, but at least we can say, okay, it's effective, it's safe, we're not seeing these immune enhancement phenomenon, and then you have your exit strategy from COVID-19. If you try to rush that, you could end up creating a bigger problem than the disease itself, which we cannot tolerate. So the bottom line is then, well, if we're not gonna have this safely in 16 or 18 months, we're doomed, right? No, we're not. This points out why it's so important to do social distancing, hand washing, listening to what they're telling you about flattening the curve, because then we slow the rate of spread of the virus, buys us time to do the vaccine right. Also, we're working in parallel on antiviral treatments, so actual other treatments for the disease itself, working on understanding how better to manage these patients when they end up in the hospital, understanding why some people get sick and some people don't, which may lead to other treatment strategies, and improving our technology to actually track cases so that if we flatten the curve, we can exit ramp this by actually testing people for antibodies that might imply they've been infected and now are immune, sending them back to work. When new cases arrive, as happens in Singapore and Hong Kong now, as people come back with infections, you can actually track them using technology, quarantine them and their contacts without shutting down the entire economy like we've had to do now because we never tested up front, all right? So there is an exit strategy. We are working on vaccines, but don't believe the hype when people talk about 12 to 18 months. That is going to take some heroic act to do that safely. And so let's work on everything at once. And you can do your part by social distancing, washing your hands, and listening to what the authorities are saying. All right, guys, do me a favor, share this video, become a supporter on Facebook or YouTube, leave a comment, watch our deeper dive interview with Dr. Paul Offit, where he goes through this, our past interviews with Dr. Peter Hotez, and other interviews that we continue to do. All right, guys, I love you. Stay safe, and we out. Peace.